Hi, it's Guesty here. You're watching Fishing the Edge. Mate, the nor'easter is pumping at home at the moment. So I ditched the boat, jumped on the old Can-Am quad bike here, load up some crib, gonna chase a few trout in the mountains. Rainbows and browns. The New South Wales fisheries are really, really good now at stocking rainbows and browns in the mountain areas here. So I've got some soft plastics, gonna work my way around, try and keep away from the snakes and hopefully catch a trout. Yes! Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo. Yeah! Oh. Woo! Yeah, baby! Oh, get out of there, brown trout. Go, you good thing. Nice brown trout. There you go. Just changed to that slightly darker coloured hog there, and that's a magnificent looking brown. Let's jump in the water here with him. He's just, oh, terrific. Oh, you gotta love the colours of these things. And, he thought more like a rainbow, that. There he is. And there's that, just pop that hog out of there. There you go, Mr. Trout. So you can see, as I said, it looks like an insect or a nymph. And there's the result. Just change to that brown, it's called green pumpkin seed, but it's sort of a bronzy brown color. Very similar color to this little brown here, actually. If I can get him out and show you. Magnificent little stream trout. The colours on that, fantastic. Oh, and if you like your photography like I do, and you want to get a great shot, that morning sun, look at that, just glowing gold there, such a beautiful fish. And this is, I guess, his dominant run. There's a couple of logs you can see here behind me. Oh, and there he goes. That's the best way to release him anyway. There's a couple of logs here behind me, so I'd say this is his run. Being early in the morning, I cast the tail end of the pool, didn't find him, didn't find a fish. Cast up the head of the pool where the rapids running down, and he's obviously up in there feeding. Put it in there, he's climbed straight onto it, bang, and there's the result. That's a nice start. See if we can get a couple more. All right, that was awesome. A big bow wake. Hey! And he's pulled out. Oh dear. Bit of aerial trout action there. Looks like a rainbow that time. First few fish I've seen have been browns, and definitely a rainbow that time. So you can see that aerial action, and this is your fisheries money at work. Every year when we buy our, certainly in New South Wales anyway, when we buy our fisheries license, we'll replace it after that 3-year period. Some of that money goes to stocking creeks, rivers and impoundments, not only with trout, but with bass and yellow belly and cod and our native species as well. But it's in action here. I'm starting to find some nice water, pretty well raising a fish in most areas. Bit unlucky to jump that one off, but I got my money's worth out of him anyway. Hey, oh. Oh, he's got me wrapped around a stick down there. Got him out. Oh, needless to say, the barometric pressure plays a big part in a lot of freshwater species, especially our natives, and trout are certainly the same when it comes to that. So a rainbow, and he's maybe hit that more out of frustration than food, because the barometer is a bit low. And you can see that hog is actually hooked underneath. I had to run down, he had wrapped around a stick there for a minute. It's gone in underneath there. So whether it's more of a territorial thing, this is my hole, and he's just trying to push this hog away as maybe a potential threat to his food source. Rainbow trout, magnificent. Without a doubt, when I'm fishing the mountains, my favourite soft plastic lure has to be these pound nymphs. This one's green pumpkin. It's sort of a chocolate brownie sort of colour. Quite a light jig head. This is a 1/32, I think. Tiny little hook in there. Simply feed it on. like so. Get that hook right down here where those feelers pop out, slide him up. And there he is. This one's actually missing one of those legs. Sometimes I even just pop those other fat legs off like that, and that just streamlines it, and you've just got those little legs there kicking along. Got him on here. Oh, it's hard work. Once again, back to that visual aspect. I spotted the brown back in there. I couldn't quite get a cast on it. I just want to let him calm down a little bit. Couldn't quite get the cast in there, and I've come up the other end here and worked a little back against the tide, which is not usually the way to go. It looks like he's fairly well hooked. I might be able to lift him out. I'm up on a bit of a high bank. It's a nice brown trout. So it's been pretty tough, 1,000 casts. As I think I've already mentioned, low barometer today, only around that 1,002, and certainly not conducive for any freshwater fish biting. But even though it's a bright sunny day, big southerly change coming, that barometer's dipped and the fishing's been tough. But look, I think I learned a little bit today just about trying to stay even further away in this crystal clear water. And luckily I leaned over the bank, spotted this brown there, and said to my mate Captain behind the camera there, oh, I'll have to run up the other side, drop the lure in, and luckily textbook manoeuvre and beautiful Barrington Tops brown trout. So yeah, I might just slide him back in the water and we'll just have a little look at the tackle I've been using. And there he goes. Don't have to spend $1 million to go trout fishing. Pretty simple stuff, 2 to 4 kilo drop shot rod, little Abu Sauron size 10, something you'd use for brim spinning, 3 pound microfuse, 4 pound vanish, a 1/50th weight jig head, slide your power hog on. This is a brown pumpkin seed colour, and I don't know whether colour makes that much difference sometimes, but this colour seems to be working. Caught a couple of fish on it. Pop him on, cast him out, catch a trout, you're in business. Oh, come here. Oh, great. Oh, hang on a second. Get out of there. Oh, a little rainbow. And it's really fast, shallow run. Just goes to show you where they'll get. Hang on a second. Oh, there he is. Hey, stop jumping around. There you go. Beautiful little, oh, my hog slid up the line there. Beautiful little rainbow. Magnificent. He's probably one of last year's, or the year before's, I guess, releases back into the system here. So that's been great. So a couple of nice browns and a rainbow and a few other bits and pieces. As I always say, there's always time for one last cast. You've been watching Fish in the Edge. This is Guesty. I'll catch you next time.